Differences between Koicha and Usucha. Koicha is usually translated as like thick tea, and Usucha is usually translated as thin tea. To make Koicha, it's like a really thick shot of matcha. You would use something like our matcha Koicha, because if you use anything that isn't necessarily designed for that, like maybe lower grades of matcha, it's not that they're necessarily bad, it's just you wouldn't want to make Koicha with it because it might be a bit too bitter. And you would use basically like three sort of heaping chashaku scoops and about 1 ounce of water. And then you would kind of knead it like a paste. You can still make it into a foam too. And for the Usucha, you would use maybe two kind of lighter chashaku scoops and about 2 ounces of water. You'd kind of make it like really foamy. So I made both here today and I thought we would try it and kind of compare. This is the matcha Usucha. Let's see. Huge fan of this one. It does have this like smooth kind of umami character, not very bitter at all. It's a little dry on the tongue afterwards, but initially has that umami kind of feel to it. Yeah, it's really good. And now let's try this Koicha. It really is kind of like a paste or like a really thick liquid, like a matcha nectar. Damn. Sorry, excuse me. There's like a lot of umami. If you let it sit for too long, it is a little bit bitter, but you really feel like the caffeine and the theanine kind of hit you immediately. This is like, you can't even see through it really. It's so thick. If you were looking to kind of get a bit more of an energy boost, I'd probably go with the Koicha. If you guys have enjoyed this video, maybe you want to try making Koicha at home with whatever matcha you might have. We recommend getting like a matcha Koicha, but I'm like a little zoned out right now because the drink. This has been David Stokes, a friend of Dim Chum. Have a wonderful day and tea time.